Ronda Rousey debuts on Raw. Paul Heyman gets the most surreal promo of all time. And Roman Reigns is all over the show. I'm Himanshu Sharma. This is Model Monster Wrestling. And this is my Raw review. And we're starting right now. Now, so the show started with Kurt Angle and Constable Baron Corbin coming out. And Angle welcomes the crowd and says that this is going to be a historic show, which it was not. And he says that Ronda Rousey is going to compete on Raw, and he praises Ronda Rousey for competing on Raw, unlike some other UFC champions. And it actually created a buzz on Twitter because Dave Meltzer said that Dan Severn and Ken Shamrock also wrestled on Raw, and some guy pointed out that some shit, and Dave Meltzer corrected him. And then we went for other things, and Angle ran down Brock Lesnar for his behavior last week and for all the things that he has done to the Universal Championship. And Kurt Angle says that Brock Lesnar has no class and he is a very bad UFC Universal Champion. And then Roman Reigns arrives and Michael Cole has an orgasm and he says the big dog. And then Roman says that what Brock Lesnar did to Kurt Angle was very wrong. And he also said that if the big dog is not going to be in this yard, then who's going to protect the yard? Which is a nice line, I think. And then he says that Baron Corbin is laughing over there. And he was just like being like a little. And then he was about to say bitch, but he stopped. Kurt Angle stopped him. And then Kurt Angle says that Roman Reigns is going to face Brock Lesnar at SummerSlam, and that's not going to stop, and there's nothing that can stop that from happening here. And then Roman accuses Baron Corbin again for not standing up to Brock Lesnar, but then Corbin says that he was already torn and he wrestled Balor that night, and he also defeated Balor, who actually beat Reigns on his first night and has been the Universal Championship, unlike Reigns. And Reigns got burned. And then Kurt Angle made the match between Roman Reigns and Baron Corbin. And then this match went for 18 minutes and 42 seconds. It went through two commercial breaks. It was a very long match, but it was alright. It was a good match. It was the kind of my thing that I wanted to see Roman Reigns against Baron Corbin. And it was fine. If they had a pay-per-view match left for like 20 minutes and so without no commercial breaks, they could have a pretty good match. And it was an okay match. Baron Corbin having a cheap shot on Reigns before the bell rang, and then he continued to beat Reigns, but then Reigns start to beat up Corbin, and then Corbin start to retreat, but then Finn Balor came out, and then Reigns hit a Superman punch on Corbin and threw him in the ring and speared him, and that was it. Roman Reigns beat Baron Corbin in 18 minutes 42 seconds. It was an okay match, but post match Finn Balor hit a John Woo on Baron Corbin, that is the shotgun dropkick, and then hit a coup de grace on Corbin, that is the double foot stomp from the top turnbuckle. And yeah, this feud must continue. This fucking feud must continue. And then we got ourselves Ronda Rousey and her best friend Natalya talking backstage and shit. And then Kurt Angle meets with Seth Rollins, and Seth Rollins want to face Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler. And Angle says that Rollins can find any partner for tonight, so that he can face Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler. Then we got ourselves Mojo Rawley versus Bobby Roode, and this match went for 9 minutes and 10 seconds, and it was nothing. It was absolutely nothing. At last, Mojo Rawley was going for the fisherman position, but then Bobby Roode countered it and hit the glorious DDT on Mojo Rawley for the win. This win meant nothing for Mojo. This win meant nothing for Roode. The crowd was not into it. It was not good stuff. The in-ring work was okay to solid, but the crowd was not invested. Nor was I invested. Nor was anyone else invested. It was boring. It was like two jobbers fighting, and I hate to say that Roode is on the same level now. Then we got ourselves Elias coming out, and he gets the cheap heat that he always gets from the crowd, that your hometown sucks and you don't have anything and all that shit. Then Lashley comes out, and Lashley says that Lashley says some stuff, and Elias accuses him of attacking him last week, and then Bobby Lashley says that you take his name one more time and he's going to beat Elias. Elias threw the notepad on Bobby Lashley and start to attack Bobby Lashley, but Bobby Lashley hit a spine buster on him and then bring the camera in man in the ring and then hit a delayed suplex on Elias. It was alright. Bobby Lashley, at least it was not the sister segment, I can say that. And I think it's going to be a SummerSlam pre-show match. Yeah, Bobby Lashley's another match at pre-show. He went from beating Roman Reigns at Extreme Rules to pre-show at SummerSlam, and Roman Reigns is in the main event. Hell yeah. Seth Rollins meets with Tyler Breeze next on Raw at the backstage segment, and the Roman Reigns says that he's going to have Seth's back tonight, and he's going to fight alongside Seth. It was a good comeback for the past FCW days, where Roman Reigns and Tyler Breeze were the FCW tag team champions, and Seth Rollins was the FCW champion. It was great. It was not great stuff. It was good. And then we got ourselves Razor versus Titus O'Neil. This match went for 2 minutes and 58 seconds. And yeah, Razor won. Because last week Apollo Crews won, and this 50-50 booking. At least Razor didn't lose. AOP is done. I didn't think that Vince would do AOP that thing because he likes big men. But I think he didn't see it in Akam and Razor. And now they are just done, I think. And this feud must continue. And yeah. And if Vince is thinking that he is putting Akam and Razor with Titus O'Neil to squash them so that they can be booked strong for the their next tag team match, it's bullshit. It's not working at all. Because they're not over with the casual audience, and the hardcore audience are starting to lose their interest on Akam and Razor, the AOP. Next up, we got ourselves the Kevin Owens show. It was a huge platform made by Kevin Owens for his stuff, and then he says that he has actually his back turned around the crowd, and then he welcomes Jinder Mahal. He praises Jinder for his work, and he says that actually at first he thought that all this Shanti and all that shit is crap, but then he started doing it, and then he actually slept pretty well and he woke up pretty well, and then he played with his kids, and also they did the impossible last week. They beat Braun Strowman. So Kevin Owens said that he wants Jinder to have another match with Braun Strowman and beat him, and then Braun Strowman sneaks out. I don't know how well such a big man can sneak out, and suddenly the stage starts to shake, and then Braun Strowman tips up the stage with Kevin Owens, Jinder Mahal and Sunil Singh's legs like surfing on it. And yeah, it was fine. It was just another Braun spot. It was just another Braun stunt and all that shit. Next up, we got ourselves Jinder Mahal versus Braun Strowman, and it was not good. As this was like Kevin Owens start to steal the briefcase, but Braun took it down, and then he started to steal the briefcase again, but then Braun took the briefcase and laid him out, and then he hit the Jinder with the briefcase and lost the match because he was DQ'd. I'm only interested in Kevin Owens. I'm not interested in Braun, and this feud is not interesting at all. I hope Kevin Owens wins the briefcase and becomes the new Universal Champion. Hell yeah. Then next up, we got us Constable Baron Corbin backstage talking to Stephanie McMahon, and then he handles the phone to Kurt Angle, and then Stephanie just cuts balls off on the telephone. And then we got ourselves a video package or a sit down interview kind of thing between Roman Reigns and Corey Graves, and Corey Graves was asking questions that some fans have turned their back on Roman and there are some haters, and the haters said that how is it going to be any different SummerSlam and all that shit, and then Roman said that him and Brock had a long history. It went for 3 years ago when he and Brock fight, and it was kind of a video package which showed their 3 year old rivalry, like they fought on at the WrestleMania where there was no definite winner between the two because Seth Rollins cashed in, and then they fought at WrestleMania 34 and Brock beat Roman, and then they fought at Royal Rumble and Roman won, which he didn't, and Roman said that he is the uncrowned universal champion, and that it was fine, it was all right. Roman Reigns was all over the show. He had the first opening segment, then he had the match with Corbin, then he had the backstage segment with Seth, then he had the sit down interview, and then he will later come on again in a short segment, but still he will be there. And next up we got ourselves Kurt Angle and Baron Corbin telling Seth Rollins that Roman Reigns cannot be his partner tonight because Stephanie McMahon refused to do so. And if Seth Rollins says Roman Reigns is his partner tonight, he will lose the title shot at SummerSlam. So yeah, next up we got ourselves Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler versus Seth Rollins in a handicap match. And it went for 7 minutes and 10 seconds. It was fun. I mean, it was not that good, but it was fun. Ziggler and Drew won by super when Ziggler hit a super kick on Rollins. It was fine stuff. Rollins was great in this match as usual. His flying stick is great, and he's a great fiery babyface. And next up we got ourselves the B team versus the Revival. This match went for 3 minutes and 12 seconds, and this was bad. It was just the crowd was not into it. B team's theme has changed, and now it is a generic bullshit. But yeah, it suits their character, but still. So yeah, it was bad stuff. And at the end, when they were both going for the hot tags, the light went off, and then blah. And then Matt Hardy was in one corner, and Bray Wyatt was in another corner, replacing their respective tag team partners. And then they took out all of them. And there was one thing that Bray refused to hit the double sister Abigail along with Matt, and then he just hit the sister Abigail, and he didn't throw another guy for the twist of fate on Matt. Yeah, it was kind of strange, and Matt was acting strange too. And yeah, I don't know what is Matt Hardy's status, because it seems like that his hips section and his pelvis are starting to get together, and it is very horrible hearing that. And yeah, it was bad stuff. Next up, we got the best segment on Raw. Maybe the best segment of 2018, and one of the best promos of all time for me. Paul Heyman cuts the most surreal promo of all time. It was great stuff. It was an interview, sit-down interview with Renee Young. And Renee Young asked him about his client Brock Lesnar, and he just teared up. And it was great stuff. Paul Heyman was unshaven, and he was terrified of Brock Lesnar, and he was like, Brock may not like this stuff and all that shit. I mean, it was great stuff. And then he said to Renee that she must be happy. You must be happy that Brock Lesnar is not with me anymore. And it was great stuff by Paul. And he had red eyes, and he was like crying, and it looked real. Paul Heyman is such a great promo, such a great promo. And then he was asked about, and then he said that his kids are friends with Brock Lesnar's kids. And Renee Young asked that if Paul Heyman considers Brock Lesnar still his friend. And he said yes, of course he considers Brock Lesnar his friend. And then she says that, asked him a question that, if Brock, there could be another guy who could be a Paul Heyman guy and all that stuff. But Paul Heyman says that it is inconceivable. I don't know what that means. And he didn't answer it. And then he said that Brock Lesnar is not interchangeable. But he didn't say that he will not choose any other guy. He said Brock Lesnar isn't interchangeable. But when Brock Lesnar is gone, another guy can come in. And then he said that, and the last line was amazing, where he said that the Brock Lesnar has never been more violent, and Brock Lesnar has never been more angry, and fighting this Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns doesn't stand a chance. It was great stuff. It was one of the most surreal promos I've ever seen, and it was not just great in terms of wrestling thing. It was not a great promo in terms of only wrestling world. It was like on the Hollywood standards of great promo. It was on the Hollywood standards of great acting. It was just that damn good. Paul Heyman should be an actor. He will do very well. Next up we got ourselves Bayley and Sasha Banks versus Liv Morgan and Sarah Logan. This match went for 10 minutes and 45 seconds. It was a solid match. At last, Sarah Logan and Ruby Riott won, and Liv Morgan won, and Ruby Riott came back and they distract Sasha Banks, and then Sarah Logan just rolled her up, and yeah, it was solid stuff. Ruby Riott came out and the Riott Squad looked pretty lost without Ruby Riott, and it will do them some favors, I think. And Bayley and Sasha Banks are really good tag team. And next up we got ourselves the main event, and then we need more time. So Charlie Cross had an in-ring interview with Bliss and Fox, and Bliss cut the same generic heel promo. And then Ronda Rousey versus Alicia Fox went for 3 minutes 47 seconds. It had too many shenanigans from Alexa Bliss and Ronda Rousey's best friend Natalya. It was all right, and at last Ronda Rousey just snapped Alicia Fox's arm, and she won. It was all right. The only good stuff in this was Paul Heyman promo, and I'm actually excited for Reigns versus Lesnar. Let's see what happens. Otherwise, this show sucked. This show had nothing. At the ratings, I will give it a 4.5 out of 10. So guys, this was my Raw review. If you enjoyed it, press a like, subscribe, and share. So guys, thank you, and have a nice day.